Above Life's Turmoil by James Allen. Foreword. We cannot alter external things, nor shape other people to our liking, nor mold the world to our wishes, but we can alter internal things, our desires, passions, thoughts. We can shape our liking to other people, and we can mold the inner world of our own mind in accordance with wisdom, and so reconcile it to the outer world of men and things. The turmoil of the world we cannot avoid, but the disturbances of mind we can overcome. The duties and difficulties of life claim our attention, but we can give rise above all anxiety concerning them. Surrounded by noise, we can yet have a quiet mind involved in responsibilities. The heart can be at rest in the midst of strife. We can know the abiding peace. The 20 pieces which comprise this book, unrelated as some of them are in the letter, will be found to be harmonious in the spirit, in that they point the reader towards those heights of self-knowledge and self-conquest, which, rising above the turbulence of the world, lift their peaks where the heavenly silence reigns. James Allen. Chapter 1. True Happiness. To maintain an unchangeable sweetness of disposition, to think only thoughts that are pure and gentle, and to be happy under all circumstances. Such blessed conditions and such beauty of character and life should be the aim of all, and particularly so of those who wish to lessen the misery of the world. If anyone has failed to lift himself above ungentleness, impurity, and unhappiness, he is greatly deluded if he imagines he can make the world happier by the propagation of any theory or theology. He who is daily living in harshness, impurity, or unhappiness is day by day adding to the sum of the world's misery, whereas he who continually lives in goodwill and does not depart from happiness is day by day increasing the sum of the world's happiness, and this independently of any religious beliefs which these may or may not hold. He who has not learned how to be gentle or giving, loving and happy, has learned very little. Great though his book learning and profound his acquaintance which the letter of Scripture may be, for it is in the process of becoming gentle, pure and happy that the deep, real and enduring lessons of life are learned. Unbroken sweetness of conduct in the face of all outward antagonism is the infallible indication of a self-conquered soul, the witness of wisdom, and the proof of the possession of truth. A sweet and happy soul is the ripened fruit of experience and wisdom, and it sheds abroad the invisible yet powerful aroma of its influence, gladdening the hearts of others and purifying the world. And all who will and who have not yet commenced may begin this day, if they will so resolve, to live sweetly and happily, as becomes the dignity of a true manhood or womanhood. Do not say that your surroundings are against you. A man's surroundings are never against him. They are there to aid him, and all those outward occurrences over which you lose sweetness and peace of mind are the very conditions necessary to your development, and it is only by meeting and overcoming them that you can learn and grow and ripen. The fault is in yourself. Pure happiness is the rightful and healthy condition of the soul, and all may possess it if they will live purely and unselfish. Have good will to all that lives, letting unkindness die, and greed and wrath, so that your lives be made like soft airs passing by. Is this too difficult for you? Then unrest and happiness will continue to dwell with you. Your belief and aspiration and resolve are all that are necessary to make it easy, to render it in the near future a thing accomplished, a blessed state realized. Despondency, irritability, anxiety and complaining, condemning and grumbling, all these are thought cankers, mind diseases. They are the indications of a wrong mental condition, and those who suffer therefrom would do well to remedy their thinking and conduct. It is true there is much sin and misery in the world, so that all our love and compassion are needed, but our misery is not needed. There is already too much of that. No, it is our cheerfulness and happiness that are needed, for there is too little of that. We can give nothing better to the world than beauty of life and character. Without this, all other things are vain. This is preeminently excellent. It is enduring, real, and not to be overthrown, and it includes all joy and blessedness. Cease to dwell pessimistically upon the wrongs around you. Dwell no more in complaints about and revolt against the evil in others, and commence to live free from all wrong and evil yourself. Peace of mind, pure religion, and true reform lie this way. If you would have others true, be true. If you would have the world emancipated from misery and sin, emancipate yourself. If you would have your home and your surroundings happy, be happy. You can transform everything around you if you will transform yourself. Don't bewail and bemoan. Don't waste yourself in rejection, nor bark against the bad, but chant the beauties of the good. And this you will naturally and spontaneously do as you realize the good in yourself.